Generally, the economic growth rate is calculated using the real GDP growth rate, which fixes prices to look at the changes in volume. This differs from the nominal GDP growth rate, which reflects the changes in prices and represents the value amount. Nominal GDP is an important economic indicator as most aspects of everyday life, for example, income, loan repayments, government budget, etc., are all expressed in terms of the amount and not volume. This discrepancy between the nominal and real GDP is called the GDP deflator. Like the core and headline CPI, the GDP deflator is an indicator for the changes in prices and shows the GDP price level. Since 2013, the nominal GDP has been highly volatile, taking a sharp downturn in recent years, while the real GDP has remained stable. This is due to the GDP deflator growth rate, but why? The result of KDI's analysis on the GDP deflator using consumption, investment, export, and import reveals that while consumer and investment prices have been relatively stable, there was considerable volatility in export and import prices. Specifically, international oil and semiconductor prices, exchange rates, and aggregate demand pressure are some of the factors that influence the GDP deflator growth rate. Since 2015, international oil prices have become the main source of volatility. In 2015 and 16, the GDP deflator rose on the back of falling oil prices and a rising exchange rate. In 2018, the GDP deflator reversed to a decline due to rising oil prices and a falling exchange rate in the first half and rising oil prices and falling semiconductor prices in the second. Based on these results, the outlook for the GDP deflator in 2019 shows that if the decline in demand eases and oil prices remain flat, while semiconductor prices maintain the downtrend of 20%, the GDP deflator will mark 0.1%. However, if demand remains sluggish and oil prices rise while semiconductor prices fall, the GDP deflator will stand at minus 0.2%. Finally, if there is a rebound in demand, oil prices fall, and semiconductor prices show a rapid recovery within the year, the GDP deflator will post 0.4%. The growth in the GDP deflator rate is expected to remain low as the downtrend from last year is expected to continue while semiconductor prices continue to fall.
경기 부진에 따라 실제 경제 성장률이 축소될 우려가 높은 가운데 GDP 디플레이터 상승률도 낮을 것으로 전망되면서 명목 GDP의 증가율까지 하락할 수 있습니다. 명목 소득 증가세가 축소되면서 발생할 수 있는 채무 상환 부담 확대, 세수 증가세 둔화 등을 주요 의사결정에 반영해야 할 것입니다. 아울러 장기적으로는 GDP 디플레이터뿐만 아니라 주요 물가 지표들의 상승세가 1%대 초반으로 축소되고 있는 현상을 방지할 수 있도록 통화 정책이 운영되어야 하겠습니다.